Okay, with me in the studio is Dibang, senior journalist, senior television journalist and analyst. Also with us is Sanjeev Kumar, member of parliament of the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, JMM. Thank you very much. He's in the Rajya Sabha. Joining us from Jamshedpur, Sariyu Rai, former BJP MLA. He knows a lot about this story. Former CBI director Joginder Singh is also joining the panel this evening. We are also joined by Anupam Gupta. He's been the lawyer in the Ashok Khemka case. He knows what it is to be on the other side of the law, try and push the system. So I'd like to thank you all for joining me. Also joining us is Rajiv Kumar, counsel for the petitioner Durga Rao in this case. Thank you very much. Kretias Tulsi, senior advocate, also joining us on the debate. You know, Dibang, the question is this: had it not been for, for the media pushing this case, nobody would have cared. This man would have lived the life of a media don, and it was almost as if this scam itself had been, the files had been closed and tucked away in some cupboard in the enforcement writ.
Congratulations to you, Arnav, for that, because you need that kind of doggedness. You have to be after a case, you have to believe in your information, you have to try again, because this is the work the investigating agencies with all kinds of facilities should be doing, but they don't do this kind of cases. We have seen repeatedly, Arnav, you would remember Kotroki, all the mafia dons have been interviewed by the media. Somehow the official agencies fail to do their work. Why is it so? I think they are vested interests. I mean, we know this character who's coming, and we know Congress, they've been disproportionate assets cases against Congress leaders after Madhu Kora's arrest. So we know more things, more worms will come out. So they want to keep the lid on it. They don't want to open the box. But I think what's happening now, and that's very important, maybe we'll talk about it later, how the media is playing a role and how it's no longer possible. It's no longer the days of Narasimha Rao when, he would say, so what? As something comes out in the media, so what? It will be there for a week, two, three days, and then it will die down. People will forget, move to the next story. But that's changing now.
I hope it emboldened the system. But Joginder Singh, isn't it shocking? The agencies do absolutely nothing. It seems the media has taken over the role of the investigating agencies in our country.
First of all, I would like to congratulate you for tracing this man. But let me tell you, neither the Enforcement Directorate nor CBI has jurisdiction on other countries. There are extradition treaties which are laid down. There are methods of investigation. You have to send a letter rogatory to those countries. They question them. They may not take interest here. We have no jurisdiction, neither you have jurisdiction. But you, as media, have advantage. You can go and talk to anybody, though you can't arrest anybody. Neither can we do it also. All you mentioned about Kutruchi. Yes, we tried our best here.
Sir, what is this? Sir, enforcement directorate.
You would notice,
sir, 1 minute. Sir, enforcement
directorate.
Sir, 1 minute. Sir, enforcement directorate can't go to Indonesia.
Saying there is no case against Kutruchi.
This man, Joginder Singh Ji. Joginder Singh Ji. He actually is wanted by the enforcement directorate. And let me tell you, he goes coolly to the Indian embassy.
No, true.
And gets his passport
but even,
renewed.
Even then, this
so on the one side, we are told in
no
India this
power
man is
to
missing.
Him.
The man goes, and I'm told he's been treated like a VIP in the Indian embassy out there. He goes and gets his passport renewed. What kind of a sham is this?
That is something for external affairs to take notice of it here. But so far as the legal procedure is concerned, no government agency either in Indonesia or in India can bypass the laws. Can bypass the Interpol rules or extradition treaties here. Of course, it's open to any government, which very few government do.
Let's be very direct. Joginder Singh Ji, our debate is warming up. Let's get everyone into the debate. Tell me, Sanjeev Kumar, what is the real story here? How is it possible that such a massive scam is perpetuated between 2005 and 2008?
Yes.
And between 2009, when the Koda diaries come out, and 2012, it appears as if the story has just vanished. 4,000 crores just vanished.
Yes. Actually, Mr. Madhu Koda and other co-accused persons must be in the police custody or custody of the prosecution. And in course of investigation, he might have revealed their names in other contexts.
Whose names?
This Bastawa Mbade and other people who were involved.
Yes.
And it was incumbent and it was duty of the prosecuting agency to keep track on him. And the man just walks in the embassy and gets his passport.
So how does that happen?
Yes. So this is the 100% negligence on the part of investigating agents.
Only negligence?
Negligence
or connivance?
No, but they may not have been informed.
To some extent, we can say that possibly.
How is a kingpin treated like a VIP? Enforcement director puts an affidavit in the Supreme Court.
So enforcement.
It says, in the affidavit, it says it is very strange that very important documents get misplaced or lost at the hands of embassy officials while diplomatic channels are considered the safest. This, coupled with the fact that no efforts were made to retrieve them, is indicative of the influence likely to have been wielded. Mr. X or Miss X was putting influence to save Anil Arinath Bastawade. Do you think so?
Yeah, Arnob, actually you will have to understand the things first. It was first of all investigated by CBI. CBI investigated the matter, and the subsequently enforcement directorate came into picture.
Sir, are more powerful politicians involved in that?
We can say so.
And do you have any doubt about it?
No, actually, unless we have concrete evidence, so with certainty we can't say. But someone very powerful must be behind all these things.
Precisely. I'm not getting into Sariu Rai. I know you have a lot of information. I like to say that I'm not getting into naming individuals, because unless we have legal proof that XYZ individual is involved, I don't want to get into naming individuals. But the bigger story is that when Madhu Koda was a chief minister, income tax officials wanted to raid him. They were not allowed to raid him. Am I correct, Sariu Rai? Am I correct?
Yes, you are right. You are correct. You are 100% correct. You are correct.
So, jab baadi khet ko khane lag gaya, what is left?
So, influence was being used to protect Madhu Koda?
Yes, very much. Entire government of the Jharkhand and the supporters of the governments at center, they tried to influence the investigation, and they also tried to hush up the matter. And scam was going before their naked eyes. And in fact, they were not in favor to hand over this case to CBI. In 3 months' rule, Sibu Sorana as a chief minister, 4 times the government appeared before the High Court with an affidavit that this case should not be investigated by the CBI. We are competent to deal with it according to our own rules and with our own vigilance. So it is the mercy of the court or decision of the court due to which the case went to CBI. So entire government from 2007 to 2011 were supporting the scamsters, and they're trying to protect them.
Yeah, and now I will hold up
excellent
parts of what I have, which are the infamous Madhu Koda diaries. Now I'm not saying this politician or that politician, but suffice to say, and without my taking names, let me say this: names of very important politicians are in these papers. Now you can argue that this is not legally valid enough evidence, but names of very important politicians are in these papers.
I'm only putting a question up today.
Why should two and two not be linked? That politicians trying to save themselves were very happy with keeping this name in Indonesia. Let him be as far away from us as possible. KTS Tulsi, classic case of
deception. Yes, right.
Classic case of attempting to conceal the truth.
Yes,
of course, any attempts at obfuscation of the truth, those people, I would say that anyone involved in screening an offender, anyone screening the offender would himself be liable to be prosecuted for destruction of evidence. This is also an offence. To try to destroy evidence or try to mislead the investigation are also serious attempts at tampering with the endeavor to discover the truth for the purpose of bringing people to justice.
So, what were the agencies doing now? So why were the agencies sleeping? Why were the agencies sleeping till now?
They are part of the government. They don't have a constitutional status Court or High Court.
Sir, please,
It's quite surprising that the media house should be able to locate the person and the intelligence agencies can't. After all, if the United States could could locate even Osama right under the nose of the Pakistan army, I wonder why our intelligence agencies couldn't locate this gentleman.
That's the biggest story.
Let the government tell them that's clearly, that's do this thing point. And they deliver the result.
Arnab, it's very simple. Or, Joginder Singh ji, let me address this point to you. You were protesting. Aap ye keh rahe the. I'm saying this. It's very simple. You are playing on behalf of the government. Let's look at Uttar Pradesh, Arnab. There are two chief ministers. Mulayam Singh Yadav, disproportionate assets case. The court tells Supreme Court, don't be a handmaiden of the government. Just before the confidence motion, 2008, July 22, the court says, okay, CBI says, okay, we will pursue the case. Mulayam Singh saves the government, Arnab, and then it's decided later in that year, they decide to withdraw the case.
Precisely.
Six times the CBI flip-flopped in that case in the Supreme Court. Let's see the other party, NDA Alliance. Mayawati, December 2012, says in the Rajya Sabha. That 2004, the BJP wanted an alliance in the elections. She said no. They said, okay, we'll start the disproportionate case, and the case is started. So CBI works on behalf of the government. You're not interested. You know that more people will come out, more names will come out. Government is not interested. Well, that's why you're not interested.
This is simple.
You don't want to do it.
CBI supposed to do its job or keep its political masters happy? Joginder Singh, let me remind you. What happened in the 2G case? What happened in the 2G case? The Supreme Court had to really pull up the CBI for its slipshod investigations, saying the same minister is continuing even today. No, so only when the court acts or the media exposes the agencies to their job. Till then, agencies are the handmaiden of politicians.
The government wouldn't give permission for that. No, but this is how it is made. Right, same. From the British time, the same police system has been continuing.
The system does not serve the interests of the people. Is there an argument? This is how the system is made.
No party,
Joginder Singh says this is the way the system is made.
Joginder Singh, that means what? That means you are not fair. You will do what the government wants to do. Whenever the government is in trouble, you will rescue them.
You will
file cases against people who are not amenable to the government.
Change it.
Is this why you are made? Is this what you're supposed to do as an investigating agency? That's the big question.
This is a very convenient...
It is not convenient. It is a fact of law. We have to go by what the law government makes.
Give me a plausible answer on this. What happened in November 2008.
You debate about rape laws by Arnab Goswami in the previous program.
I want to get in Anupam Gupta here. He's fought. He's been Ashok Kemka's lawyer in another case. He has strong views on it. Anupam, where do you stand on this? Joginder Singh says this is the way the system is. So should we leave it to the Supreme Court of India and to news channels to carry out investigations and have them followed up?